they have also very easy topic with Sitara. It is very useful for all the departmental examinations of every Air Force department. Besides this, Mr. Rameshwar Rao also has a blog, which is called as Appendix 3A exam blog. It is very useful. It has a lot of current information and it can be accessed by each and everyone who is interested in getting their examination. Mr. Rameshwar Rao, besides being our instructor at Sitara, to take two classes in STC, ZRTI and other institutions. We are indeed fortunate to have him as our speaker today. Over to Mr. Rameshwar Rao.
Yeah, good morning, all of you.
Back buildings,
Transportation also national land, surround capital. Let us come up to the India expenses and routine expenses. The government should be regular or the recurring expenses. That is the purpose of maintenance of the fixed assets or day-to-day expenditure. So capital expenditure is increases the earning capacity. Capital expenditure is the increases the earning. Suppose the railway is at rolling stock. So being the rolling stock, you can earn more revenue. But revenue expenditure, it is to maintain the existing assets or earning capacity. Maintenance. What are the maintenance of expenditure? Normally it is a repairs and maintenance or operating expenses or establishment charges or miscellaneous charges for lines. So capital expenditure is a non-recurring. Suppose if you purchase a motorcycle, you will not purchase again and again. But if you purchase provisions, again you have to purchase next week or next month. So it is a recurring. Revenue means recurring expenditure. And capital expenditure is produces benefit over several years. That means it lost more than one year. The expenditure which we incurred is lost more than 1 year is called capital expenditure. Conversely, this expenditure which is lost less than 1 year is called revenue expenditure. Suppose if you pay rent, this covers only 1 month. Suppose if you repair the vehicle, it costs only 1 month or 2 months. Again, it needs repairs, maintenance, it's all recurring. So, all capital expenditure goes to balance sheet, and all revenue expenditure, it is an income and expenditure, or profit and loss. This is the small example of this capital and revenue expenditure. And I want to take one small is on this revenue capital expenditure. Yeah, please choose the odd man out from this item. Please submit your answers. Yeah, only 1 minute or 2 minutes time. Please submit.
Sir, no volume. You are muted. Please, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Please choose one item different from other three items. After end of phone, we'll discuss. Now please be fast. Yeah, should I end the call? Yeah. Quarterly. What is the reason for choosing that school? please tell me? Anyone? Some people are subordinates or choose provisions. What is the reason for provisions? Okay, what is the reason for choosing furniture? Most of the participants choose businesses. Participants choose furniture. What is the reason?
Sir, more assets, sir.
Pardon, sir, because the school fees, petrol, and the remaining costs are all reoccurring expenditures. Only furniture is the fixed assets, and we don't have to make an expense to that.
It's benefiting here.
Yeah, that's sufficient.
See, the school fees quarterly payments means we have to pay another 3 times within the year. That means the expenditure lost less than 1 year. So it is called revenue. Petrol hardly comes 1 week or 10 days. So again it is a recurring expenditure, petrol. So this is also a revenue expenditure. Provisions depend on the family composition. It may last 1 month or 20 days or 2 months. But we have to purchase the provisions again and again. So that is also a recurring expenditure. Recurring means a regular, recurring, routine expenditure. All this called as revenue expenditure. Whereas furniture, that is for a life, maybe it is more than 1 year, maybe 5 years or 2 years. So here the amount is not criteria. The nature of the item, whether it is lost more than 1 year is called capital expenditure, lost less than 1 year is called revenue expenditure. And another example of this revenue expenditure is all units expired or whatever expenditure is expired within the 1 year is called revenue. Whatever expenditure is unexpired, that means it is continued to year to year, it is called capital expenditure. That is the reason furniture is posted in the balance sheet, because it is carried forward to year to year, whereas all other expenditure, that is the repairs, maintenance, administration, all these expenditure we charge to income and expenditure account or profit and loss. That is closer to P&L account or closer to income and expenditure. So these expenditure is need not carried forward year to year. So, I hope you understand this one. We will continue the presentation. So, next, we have to understand the demands. We have S12 demands, 16 demands are there. But though all 16 demands are subsumed in single demand, all 16 demands are subsumed, but still we are following the demand numbers as first 2 digits in the revenue allocation. So we have to follow the finance code value 2 for practical purpose. Though they are not called really as demands, because all are subsumed in the single demand. So we have to know what are the S12 demands. Now, see, all demands are placed in the order as per their activity or as per their importance in the legal entities, because they are systematically arranged in 1 to 16. According to the question. Now we will discuss what is the first demand, what is the second demand, what is their order, which. Just now we discussed what is revenue and what is capital. So revenue demands are bifurcated 15 categories, whereas capital, it is the only single demand. That is the 16, demand number 16. So now we check what are the revenue demands. Again, revenue demands broadly categorized in three categories. The first category is relevant, and second category is ordinary working expenses, and third category is also relevant. So, all these 15 demands are called as gross working expenses. Gross working expenses. So, now this gross working expenses will check one by one. The first demand is demand number 1, value code. Demand number 1 is the value code. It covers all value code expenditure only value code expenditure it covers. It is like a super bus. Because in the Zonal Railway, is the GM is the in charge, whereas Indian Railways has a whole railway board is the supreme authority. So naturally it occupies the first demand. And the next demand is the miscellaneous expenditure. Here you please remember miscellaneous expenditure, Indian Railways has a own, this is the demand number 2. If you come to Zonal Railways, the miscellaneous expenditure, it is the demand number 2 and 1, you can remember easily. So, what are the items covers under this miscellaneous expenditure? Indian Railways has a own means RRB, Railway Recruitment Board, Audit, Survey, all CTIs, Centralized Training Institutes, that is IRIPAM, NAYAN, IRISET, SITARA, CTI, and all miscellaneous expenditure that is not within zonal control but within the under control of railway board. So all these expenditure comes under demand number. Now these first and two are under control of railway board. Now we'll check what is ordinary working expenses, that is 3 to 30. Because 1 to 15 it is called as gross working expenses, but 3 to 13 it is called as ordinary working expenses. It is under Zonal Railways control. So here this, for easy understanding, this 3 to 13 also is divided into 4 categories. The first category is administration. Second category is the repairs and maintenance of the railway assets, and third category is the operating expenses, and fourth category there is no common name, it is classified as the others, other than these three categories. So we discuss one by one. The first demand is ordinary working expenses, it is the 03, general superintendents and services. Here, general superintendence is one part and services is another part. So, general superintendence, what is the administration in the Zonal Railway? It is entire GM office and coming to divisions, entire DRM office, including all departments. To take GM office or Zonal headquarters, we have accounts, personal, stores, mechanical, engineering, electrical. Only exceptions to this demand is medical and security and claims. These three departments are excluded. Other than all three departments, all departments comes under this administration. And coming to second part, services means we have three departments of their service departments. Accounts, personnel and stores. These three departments, wherever they work, whether they are working in the GM office or DRM office or field units, their salaries and their expenditure charged to demand number 3 only. But for other departments, suppose if it is a mechanical department, the officer who is working in the, as a CME or CWE in the GM office only comes under demand number 3. Suppose same officer is transferred and posted as the workshop, field unit, his salary is charged to elsewhere, not demand number. But his accounts, personal, stores, wherever they work, their salary is charged under demand number 03, because it is covers under second part of the services. The first part is superintendence, that means administration. Okay? Now, The second part, it is called the core demands are there. Repairs and maintenance of railway assets. That is 4, 5, 6, 7. So, first we classify all railway assets as under these four categories. What is the first important asset? Because we have so many assets are there. Track, buildings, station buildings, quarters, and rolling stock, machinery. All these assets we can classify under this four categories. So the first and foremost important is the track. First and foremost important asset is track. So all repairs or maintenance of the track as well as works. Works means all buildings and all inanimate constructions, whether it is a bridges, we can call it as an entire engineering department center. Entire engineering department comes under this zero. But remember, this construction of new line is not comes under this demand number. This is only pertaining to repairs and maintenance of the asset. Suppose if it is the construction of new line, it goes to only demand number 16 only. Construction of building, demand number 16. Okay, construction of bridge, demand number 16. Here it is only repairs and maintenance. So this repairs and maintenance of railway and works, it goes to demand number. Then the next important asset is the rolling stock. Rolling stock also again classified in two broad categories. One is loco, another is the coaches and wagons. So among these three items, again locomotives is the very important. So that's why the next demand number is assigned to locomotives. Here also repairs and maintenance of locomotives. Here steam locomotive, diesel locomotive, electric locomotive, all locomotives, that means electrical locoshed and diesel locosheds all come under this demand. So after this locos, the next one is the carriages and wagons. That means all the example is Lalaguda workshop. Wagon workshops, coach repair shops, and open for this maintenance of all carriages and wagons comes under demand number 6. And the last one here is machinery and land and equipment. Here this is the universal demand. Why it is called universal demand means because every department is having machinery and land, whether it is a mechanical, electrical, engineering, even for accounts of subs, we have some machinery. So here repairs and machinery of all plant and equipment is comes under demand number 7. With this, the second group that is called repairs and maintenance group is over. 4, 5, 6. Then next, the next group is called operating expenses. It is the group is consists of three demands. It is covering only complete operation expenses. In the operating expenses, who is the important person, who is the important staff person, is the loco pilot. So loco pilot is the very important person. And the next important person in the rolling stock, this operating side is the guard station person. So we will check one by one. So demand number 8 is called operating expenses, rolling stock and equipment. Operating expenses, rolling stock and equipment. You can find the difference. If the rolling stock is maintained at the workshops on the open line, it is comes under demand number 4, 5, 6, 7. But when it comes to operating side, all operating expenses in relation to rolling stock and equipment is the same as in the equipment. It is comes under demand number 8. This is the difference. Now, previous category is the repairs and maintenance. The current category is the operating expenses. That is the running of the trains. So, loco pilot salary, assistant loco pilot salary, and all other expenses of these, any expenses connected with the loco, coach, wagon, including this cleaning of the coaches, cleaning of the coaches, also it comes under demand number 8. So after a local pilot, who is the next important person in the Rolling Star tribe is, he is called God. So now we check this. Demand number 9 is operating expenses profit. Operating expenses profit. It is entirely centric of this operating and commercial equipment. The common name of this operating and commercial is profit. So who are the staff working and the commercial and the operating is guard, assistant guard, station master, assistant station master, pointsman, the ticket collector, booking office, and control room staff in the DRM office. They are also both they are working in DRM office, but the salaries charged to this demand number 9, operating expenses come. Because their work is connected with the operation of the clients. And the last demand under this 8, 9, 10 group is the premium. This is very, very important. Because this demand alone constitutes 20 to 25% of total working expenses. That means if you are able to control this expenditure demand number 10, we can control this 20 to 25% of total expenditure. So what are the constraints concerned with this PL is, it is a high speed diesel or biodiesel or traction. Nowadays this traction is very, very important. Because of railway policy to convert all to traction. So with this, the third group also is completed. The first group is administration, second group is the repairs and maintenance, and third group is the operating expenses. So we covered 3 to 10, that is almost 8 minutes. Now the leftover demands are 11 to 11, 12, 13 under ordinary work expenses. So after end of duty, what staff wants? They want to relax. They want to take care of their families. They want to take care of their themselves as well as their families. So whatever expenditure railways incurred towards the staff welfare or staff measures, it is concerned at demand number 11. See, please check the examples. That means railway institutes, railway quarters, hospitals, railway schools, railway colleges, staff canteen. See, here, staff canteens concerned at demand number 11. Whereas this catering, this railway station car or the railway station department catering comes on the demand number 2. So the canteen expenditure goes to this staff welfare and amenities level. So the next demand is last two demands, last one is 12 demand is some small categories of expenditure we are not covered under 3 to 11. Such those are the examples. Because security is not covered in the earlier demands. And training institute also is not covered. Training institute, ZRTI, zonal training centers or supervisors training centers center under zonal level. If you check this demand number 2, it is CTI, centralized training institutes, all India ready. That is 2. This is a 12. Demand number 2 is the miscellaneous expenditure general. This demand number 12 is the miscellaneous working expenses. The first one is concerned the railway control. This 12 is concerned the zonal railways. So whatever leftover categories, that small miscellaneous items, that is security main important, and departmental catering, and training, and cash awards, hospitality expenditure. Suppose the railway minister is inauguration of new train or something. So all expenditure in connection with this hospitality and organizing the functions, cash award and compensation claims. That is the reason this claims department is not concerned with demand number 3. Though it is an officer working at the journal office, but his salaries and his expenses coming under demand number 1. our medical expenditure, medical department expenditure is concerned that you have the So, one security, cash awards, time ministries, claims, or whatever is not covered at the premium level is concerned. And the last stage of the life employee and the last demand at the 3 to 13, that is the ordinary working expenses, is demand number 13. So, that is the final demand under ordinary working expenses. Also, it is a final stage of the employee. So, here it covers pension expenditure, BCRG, leave encashment, all related retirement benefits comes under demand number. Now, as I told you, the first and second is railway control, 3 to 13 is the ordinary working expenses, and 14 and 15 is again railway control. Now we check what are the 14 and 15. Before that, please have a glance on the this table. This 3 is one color code, one separate, and 4, 5, 6, 7 is the group repairs and maintenance. 8, 9, 10 is the operating expenses, and 11, 12, 13 is the others. There is no common name. That is 11 means stock welfare, 12 is miscellaneous working expenses, and 13 is pension and the other expenses. With this ordinary working expenses is closed. Now we check 14 and 15. This 14 is the appropriation to all funds, whether it is a DRF, pension fund, capital fund, RRS, all types of funds. That means the surplus will are appropriated to all funds. So this is the demand covers appropriation to all funds. And demand number 15 is dividends payment to general revenues and repayment of loans taken from the general revenues. But however, the merger of railway budget happens here in 2017 and 18. Afterwards, this dividends is not required because the loan capital or capital charge is ceased to itself. There is no capital charge, so there is no question of dividends also. But here again, however, it is remaining in the books. So this demand is not relevant. Now this is the single demand for this capital expenditure. Single demand for capital expenditure, that is nomenclature is assets, acquisition, construction, and the replacement of the assets also, that is DRF comes under this demand number 16. That means maintenance of assets comes under revenue, whereas creation or construction or acquisition of the all the assets comes under demand number 16. This is capital. Earlier all demands is the yeah, any doubts, so far please tell me regarding this demands and otherwise I will go to next topic.
Hello.
Yeah, 10 minutes, Rush.
Sir, motorman salary demand, which demand man?
Please tell me clearly.
Hello, motorman salary.
Motorman means auto pilot?
No sir, Mumbai local train, Mumbai local train.
Commercial.
Demo, it is classified as the carriages and wagons, not locomotive.
The motorman.
Yeah, motorman service, it is charged to demand number 6. Because all memo coaches, demo coaches are classified as the carriages and wagons, not locomotive.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, PPT I disabled. Any doubts, please ask me, otherwise I will continue with the PPT.
Sir, relation between demand number 83 and old demands from 1 to 16.
Yeah, now 1 to 16 is only we are using for allocation purpose. But for communication of budget and other allocation of budget and the distribution of budget purpose, that is the single demand aid, is only for allocation purpose. Because though the demands are subsumed, the finance code 2 is not changed so far. Finance code 2 is not changed so far. Still it is remained in the first, so we have to use all the demand numbers as the first 2 digits for allocation. Okay.
Sir, diesel said convert to sir electric said. Which operate demand number?
Yeah, teacher salary. Teacher is concerned of railway school. So it is goes to demand number 12. All railway schools teachers are teacher salary demand number 12.
Sir, diesel said convert to electric said.
Sir, sound is not.
For diesel shed convert to electrical, it is a conversion expenditure goes to demand number 16, not revenue demands.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, please elaborate demand number 15. Because demand number 15 is nothing but it is a dividends payable to Minister of Finance. That is not
sir, relevant. Not clear. Huh? Sir, not clear. Railway teacher.
Pardon?
Railway teacher payment.
Yeah, railway school teacher is concerned under miscellaneous staff welfare, demand number 11.
11?
Yeah, all railway schools and colleges see whatever expenditure is incurred towards staff welfare, it is concerned under demand number 11.
Retired RPS, retired teachers.
Sir,
demand number 83 mein kya hota hai?
Pardon?
Demand number 83 में क्या होता है?
Yeah, demand number 83 now it is for communication purpose. It is for academic purpose only, not for practical.
Sir, repair and maintenance of railway quarters.
Railway quarters it is concerned with demand number 11.
Repairs and maintenance.
Pardon?
Repair and maintenance of railway quarters, Bangalore.
Yeah, repairs and maintenance again it is concerned with demand number 11.
Please repeat demand number 83.
Maintenance of the buildings.
Sir, please repeat demand number 83.
Demand number 83, I'll come to this in PPT. Please wait.
Sir, retired RPS staff.
Yeah, demand number 14, appropriation fund means taking loans from private sectors like LSE. No, it is incorrect. Because it is actually outside of the railway scope. Whatever loans taken from this LIC or anything, it is not concerned with this budget. It is concerned with extra budget and resources.
Sir, wagon maintaining the headquarter division. Wagon maintain division your headquarter.
I am not getting, please tell me.
Hello.
Sir, RPF staff.
RPF
demand number 12.
Retired.
RPF, security.
Retired RPF.
Retired?
Retired, it is demand number 13.
13?
Retired RPF, RPF.
All retired, 13.
Notice,
we
have just in the process of closing the job.
Yeah, now again I am muted, I will continue this PPT. Yeah, this is the single demand. What is the single demand for 2021-22? That is current financial year is 84. Why it is happened, why it is changing from 80, 81, 82, we will check. Because this is the major change happened after merger of this railway. Because prior to 2017 and 18, we are supposed to play, we are presented our railway budget directly to parliament. So at that time we will have this demand number 1, 2, 3 up to 16. But due to merger, now this 16 demands are replaced by single demand number, it is allotted by the Ministry of Finance. Because now we have to prepare estimates and submit it to Finance Ministry. And Finance Ministry is consolidated with all the ministries and they are presented general budget to the Parliament on the February 1st. So that is the reason they are alerted the single demand number 84. But this demand number is changed year to year. We'll check. Yeah. If you check in the first year, that is 2017 and 18, the first year of regular budget, we are allotted the demand number 80. The next year it was changed to 81. And again the next year it changed to 82 and again 83. Now presently it is a 84. Presently 84. We don't know the next year it may be 84 or it may be 83 or 82 or 85 or 86. It is all depend on the inclusion and exclusion of the some of the departments or ministries into the Union Government of India. See, in the total we have, in the Government of India total we have 54 ministries. Total number of demands is 101. So the demand numbers assigned to the ministries as per alphabetical order. Alphabetical order means to take agriculture ministry, they are having demand number 1 and 2 because alphabetically they are concerned first. And the atomic energy demand number is 3. And if you check the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, being Y is the last digit, last but one, the last demand number 101 is assigned. So railways being R is the in the middle of alphabets, it is changing as per the some of the so next year another demand department is added. So our number may be increased or decreased. So this the Ministry of Finance is having total number of demands involved under Ministry of Finance. Home Affairs, they are having 11. Defense, 4 demands. Railways, only 1 demand of measure of this. All other ministries, that is around 50 ministries are there, there are 73 demands. So, being the railways in the middle of this alphabet clutter, we are having this 80, 81, 82. But please note, this is only for budget communication only. This is for preparation of budget and budget allotment and budget order purpose only. Not relevant for this allocation purpose. Our allocation is remain stands good as per the finance board value 2 and as per the actual demands 1 to 16 only. Now we'll check this. So what is the major act? This is already existed in the long back. But it is only for accounting purpose and other impact purpose we are used. And if you check some of the suspense allocations and other than this revenue and capital allocations, you can identify easily this major head number. Can anyone remember, please check this income tax allocation. It is always stopped with 00, 00, 21 and the last 2 digits are 01 or 02 something. Interest on HPA or sport advance, it is a 0049 allocation. And major act number also. And earnings side, 2 major acts are there, important. That is 1001, that is Indian Railways miscellaneous receipts. And 1002, Indian Railways commercial lines revenue receipts. And coming to expenditure side, these 2 acts are very, very important. 3001, that is a Indian Railways policy formulation, direction, research and other miscellaneous organization. That means the estimated demand number 1 and 2 is concerned and measured at 3001. And the 3002 is a demand number 3 to 14. Demand number 3 to 14 is concerned and measured at 3002. And this is anyway, this is strategic lines, it is only existed in the court zone readers, that are defense lines. And if you check this capital expenditure, that is the extra demand number 16, it is comes under 0002, but it is not for allocation purpose, it is not. This is the booking of expenditure. See, the difference between demands and the major expenses, demands for asking the funds to parliament, major head and sub-major head, minor heads are for 15,000 expenditure to private accounts. That means when the accounts are submitted to finance ministry, it is only as per major head wise, not our minor head or sub-head. It is a group under major. And if you check this SPA allocation or work cycle allocation or complete allocation, we start with the 007610. That means this 7610 is the major entry. And if you check this PF allocation also, it is 8009. That is major entry. Insurance, group insurance, 8011. All deposit allocation, I think, you can remember easily. Now we regularly use the allocation of deposit allocation, that is 8.45. Check sample 8670 and 8677 is the RIP. All this transfer transactions among the journal values is the 8797. Now we'll check what is the hierarchy of this major head to object head. What is the hierarchy? Is it visible? Yeah. Please check. This is the hierarchy of the
I am
taking the example of HRA of the BFA. See, what is the major head? It is concerned all 3 to 14 demands concerned 3002 major head, that is Indian Railways, commercial lines, working expenses. Under this head, again this this is the new one created of the major of Israel of this sub-major head. Now this is the sub-major head number is 01. The estimated amount is 03, but sub-major head is 01. So, this is 01. And again this sub-major head is divided into various minor heads. What are the minor heads? 100 to 900. 100 is the general management, 200 is the financial management, 300 is the personal, 400 stores, 500 engineering, 600 mechanical, 700 electrical, 800 SMT, 900 operating. For each, because it is the demand number 3 is our general superintendents and services at GM level and ERM office. So here, this is the example is the HRA of the PFA. Na? So PFA is concerned with general superintendent service and accounts management. That is financial management. So minor head here is the 200. And again, this minor head is divided into various subheads. Various subheads means 210 is accounts, 210. Another subhead is the cash and debt. Another subhead is the stock preparation line. So we have to choose 210 is the accounts. And again, this next one is the retail head. The subhead also is called as subordinate head. Again, next one is the retail head. Retail head, again, the support subhead is bifurcated into 211 officers, 212 establishment, 213 contingents like that. So we have to choose since PFA is the concerned offices category. And the last one is called object head or primary unit. Primary unit means here, if you check the this finance cannot run into a debt of this revenue classification. There are lot of primary units. So this is the example of HRA. We have to check this HRA. So finally, this major head and sub major head will not come into picture of the allocation practical. In the allocation practical, again, we have to take 03 only. S12 event, which is as per finance core value. So this now allocation is 03, that is the demand number, S12 demand number. This next digit 0 is added because of this IPAS synchronization. And 211, this 200 is the minor head, 210 is the sub head, and 211 is the detailed head. Finally, this 211 is allocation. And the last two digits is the primary, that is 0. So this is the hierarchy, that is from major head, sub-major head, minor head, sub-head, detail head, object. But our allocation is not from only minor head to object head. Only minor head to object order only this allocation is part. Again we have to prefix this allocation, the S12 demand 0. I'll show one more example. This is the HRA of the BFA. How many digits are there in the revenue allocation? It is the 8 digits. 8 digits. So the first two digits is the S12 demand number, that is 03, and third digit is because of IPAS is added, it is always 0, and 456 is the minor head, sub head, detail head. What is minor head here? 200 financial. What is sub head? 210 is accounts. What is detail head? 211 offices. What is 04 lost primary unit? Object of expenditure. Our object head or primary unit is called 0. This is called revenue allocation. And I show this finance code value to this is the finance code value to this is 1979 April 1st it was effective. Till now it is we are used and it is lauded by the several institutions, even Institute of Chartered Accountants of India also. It is appreciated the structure, how we are using this finance code to this allocations and all. If at all this accrual accounts is introduced in the Indian Railways, this finance code is with the small modification, that is maybe primary unit for the depreciation, that is small modification, we can use this F2 even for the actual accountants also. That is the beauty of this finance code value group from 1979. It is revised and it still existed. We check this. Now, this check. This is the demand number 3. Or at present, what is the sub major head? 1. Okay. I'll check, I'll show you how mapping of this demands on the sub major heads. Okay. Yeah. Please check this minor head. Minor head, I told you now 100 to 900. 100 to 900, 9 separate departments. 100 is, this is general management, that means GM office or DRM office. And this work study and planning, commercial advertisement, vigilance, legal self part. After 200, this is the financial management. Here again it is subdivided into subheads. Subdivided into subheads, it is a 210 accounts. In the present example, I take this PFA, HRA, PF. See, the 200 is minor head, 210 is the subhead, and 211 is the office. Suppose if it is the HRA of the SSO or AE discounts through or to power systems. See, please remember this finance for value 2 is not meant for by heart. Maybe if you check the either English version or Hindi version, it is roughly comes around 60 to 70 pages. Out of that, you have to download and take the print out whatever is relevant to your work. Suppose if you are passing the salary piece of the administration or accounts office, you have to take only note on 200, 210, 211, 212, 213. And next, the first subject is 210 accounts and 220 is the cashier. That means if it is the passing of salary bill of the cashier or cashiers, it is comes under 220. If it is the statistical card, 230. If it is EDPM, it is a 240. Or it is a miscellaneous use. So coming to minor heads, 200 financial management, 300 personal, that means all personal department salaries, officers, staff, functional management, 400 stores, 500 engineering, 600 mechanical, that is rolling stock department, 700 electrical, 800 SLP, 900. And we'll check the mapping of how to change this demand number to sub-major head. What is the structure of this sub-major head? What is the structure of major head? We'll just check. This is the mapping of erstwhile demands to how the single demand is. This is only for academic purpose, not for organizational purpose. Now please check our actual demands are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 16. Now how they are grouped under major head and sub-major head, please check. See, the first and second demand is comes under major head and 3001. Indian Railways policy, formulation, direction, research and other mysterious companies. This is the major head covering the S2L demands 1 and 2. Okay. So here there is no sub-major head for railway board and miscellaneous expenditure. What is the demand number railway board? Demand number 1. What is the demand number 2? This is CPI and RRP and surveys. This is demand number. There is no sub-major head number because only two segments are not submitted. So here the sub-major head is not complete. And the next one, important one is the major head 3002 Indian Railways commercial lines working expenses. And another head is there, another major head, that is 3003. Indian Railways strategic plans, that is comes under defense. But because that is very only 2-4 railways existed, so not important. Now here this is important mapping. This demand number 3 is changed as the sub-major head 1. Demand number 3 is changed as the sub-major head 1. Demand number 4 is changed to demand number sub-major head 2. That means if please check, 5 is 3, 6 is 4, 7 is 5. That is nothing but if you detect 2 number from the erstwhile demand number, you will arrive sub-major head. You need not by heart. Because 3 is 1. Suppose 10 is 8, 13 is 11, and 14 is up to 14 only. Okay. This is sub-major head. And coming to this, 16, this is the comes under the major head 5002 capital outlay on Indian Railways commercial lines. Here also, this is also now removed, this 01 and 02. This is also no sub-major head. No sub-major head. because it is the only one segment. Only one segment on the bicurricular. And strategic lines are existed only in the Northern Railway, Northeastern Battalion Railway, and Western Railway, and Northwestern Railway. These four zonal railways have maintained the accounts in two types. That is, one is strategic lines, another is commercial lines. All the rest of the zonal railways are maintained only commercial lines. Now, I wish to launch on a small quiz on this demand numbers and sub-major end. You please submit just 5 minutes time. Yeah. Now please submit just 5 minutes. Some people are not able to submit because they may be logging in through mobile. So those who are logging through mobile, they are not able to I am unmute all of you. Please tell me any queries. Laptop, maybe it is a not updated version of the tool.
Sir, one doubt, sir. Sir, one doubt, sir. Sir, one doubt. Hello?
Yeah, please tell me.
Sir, the assistance of Government Railway Police, that's your under which demand, sir. Government Railway Police, State Government Railway
Police. Government Railway Police, sir.
Not, which said, sir?
Miscellaneous working agents. Please register your queries in the chat box also. Please specify what is the activity. Tower wagon means public store. So carriages and wagons. Demand number 6. Reimbursement expenses. Reimbursement means reimbursement of medical or education. Education means it is concerned at demand number 11. But medical also it is concerned at 11. Staff welfare. Reimbursement of tuition fees or children education allowance or reimbursement of medical expenses. Yeah, please explain the demands for grant and major health expenditure. How they are different? Yeah, demands is for asking the funds to parliament, whereas major health for booking of the expenditure. Major health for booking of the expenditure, the demands for asking the grant. One has to pick all the answers, otherwise you cannot be able to submit. I will upload all these PPT and documents at the end of session. Demand of production units. Production units all comes under demand number 16. See, normally these production units are WMS plan at 72.
Nowadays, we are seeing the expectations are coming to binding due to the electrical locos they are operating. Sometimes some electrical locos are also maintained by the diesel sheds. So if we get the experiment, suppose a
local... Now, whether it is a diesel locos or electrical locos,
I'm okay with that. I'm just asking if suppose the tag loco is maintained by the diesel shed, the electrical loco is maintained by the diesel shed, sir.
Okay.
So can we book under 531 or 531?
Whatever the subject is pertained to diesel loco, we have to use for diesel, whether it is done by anyone. Whether it is done by electrical location or diesel location, that is not relevant. Whether the item is diesel or local, it has to refuel at second level.
Okay, if it is electrical loco and maintained by the diesel shed, then we only book
the item. No, we have to allocate to electrical only. Not
electrical only.
Who is the PUH is not important.
चाहे वो अंबानी को कोई शारीरिक कष्ट होगा या किसी को
अच्छा बराबर
है ये सवाल में सैलरी ऑफ आरटीएस ऑफिशियल्स इज कंसर्न विद डिमांड नंबर 2 या द पीएच पावर पॉच इज अ पीएट एंड रेज्ड ऑन द डिवीजन and division they are charged to demand number 6. Yeah, can I end the poll? Please ensure all are submitted or not.
Sir, plan head 42 or 72 में क्या अंतर है?
Pardon?
Plan head 42 and 72, sir.
Plan head 42 is the workshops. So, any new workshop is constructed that is charged to plan head 42. Then plan at 72 is the WMS, the operations of the workshop or the production units. They are regular operations, they are charged to WMS planning. 42 is for construction of new workshop, new production units.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I'm going to end this poll. Please tell me if anyone wants to try. Can I end the poll?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now please check. Yeah, very good. The salary of PFA is chargeable to S12 demand number 3. Exactly. Suppose if it is the ask for sub-major head, it is the sub-major head 1. Because the rule is the S12 demand number minus 2 is equal to sub-major head. This rule is applied only demand number 3 to 14 only. Because demand number 1, there is no sub-major head. Demand number 2, there is no sub-major head. Very good answer. Almost 88% choose the correct answer, demand number 3. Very good. Retirement benefits. Exactly. It is the last demand of the ordinary working expenses and last stage of the employee. Very good. 95%.
But other than all allocations, we have to
use the estimated demand number revenue at the revenue allocation, the first revenue system only, as per estimated demand only, as per finance code value only. Now we'll check the capital allocation another 10 minutes, then I will end the session. The capital allocation 8 digits. Only difference is the first 2 digits. The revenue allocation is the demand number, estimated demand. Whereas in the capital, it is the only single demand, 16, so not required. Here important is source of finance. Source of finance means how that money is procured for creation of the SS. Whether it is from the capital or ERM, our development fund, our RR estate, our IRFC, decides the first 2 digits. Here, I have taken examples, trials expenditure and the planet, new lines, that is planet number 11. This is, I have taken the example. See, the capital allocation, this is also 8 digits. The first 2 digits is the source of finance. This is the only difference between the capital. Is the estimated number, the capital, source of funds. See, our code of difference is the line in the earlier, the revenue allocation is a minor error, difference, minor error, subhead and dependent. Our last 2 digits is the primary. But remember, this primary units is different from the revenue primary units. Some of the primary units is common for revenue to capital, but other primary units differ from revenue to capital. So we have to check the finance code value for asset any allocation to any. Yeah. Here, rights expenditure, we check the what is major act. This major act is the 5002 capital outlay of railways commission rights. This is only for information purpose, not for allocation purpose. That means the entire demand number 16 expenditure is equal to major act 5002, but it is not affecting the allocation. The reflecting allocation is only started with the source of finance. Here, source of finance is the capital. Capital means it is the 2-0. And it comes under estimated demand number 16, but 16 also he has no room for this allocation. And next, we have to check the planet. All planets are nothing but minor heads of the capital. So here, what is the minor head of planet? It is the 11th. So it is 1100. And we will check the subhead. What is the subhead? Subhead is the 1140. So we have to check 1140. Again, we have to check this detail head. That is 1141. That is the rails and plastics. So 1140. This last 2 digits is the primary unit, that is object of expenditure. Here it is the contractual payment because contract has done the bulk of its rights and new lines. So it is the 0. Now we check some of the important changes in the primary units and changes in the planets recently. Come back to PPT. Please check the primary unit. These are all available in the finance code value group. the revenue is separate, capital is separate, the recent changes, important changes. Previously, this electricity is included in the utilities BU 22, but now that is excluded and we are assigned it another BU, that is BU 30. And 26 is for reimbursement of medical expenses. And 27 is the cost of materials from the stock. But however, here in the demand number 10, if the cost of material from the stock for home locos is at PU number 27. But if it is the by foreign railways, the PU is the different, 60. Previously, both for home railway and foreign railway is the PU 27. Now it is changed. For locos fueled by foreign driver, the PU would be 60. And this remuneration of to re-engage staff and officers, consultants is the 29. And this cost of energy, this is the very important change. Previously, the payments to this DISCOMs are state electricity boards and non-traction purpose. We use PU 30 to contraction payment. But to control this expenditure, we are assigned in new PU, that is 3-0-30. And 31 is fuel for other than that. See, if it is a fuel for this, other than traction, which is an example, smart machines, road vehicles, or stock cars, or it is a direct purchase of fuel discharged to PU 31. And one more important change is the PU 33 we are using for transfer of debits and credits for all other units, including GTCAM debits and credits. But for control of this GTCAM debits, they created a new PU, PU 61. So this GTCAM debits and credits are excluded from the PU 33. And this the clearance of this WMS to revenue, labor, and it is a 34 and 35. Previously, it is used for home driver rolling stock and as well as foreign driver rolling stock. But now we have created 63 and 64 for foreign driver rolling stock. So this is only used for home driver. And area payments is basic to DA and other analysis is 42, 44. And laptops purchased by officers 52 and 53 LDC. This fear from stock is the home driver locus fuel by partner that is 60. This GPCAM is 61. And this foreign driver rolling stock WMS to revenue. This is 63, 64. And due to this introduction of GST, these four fees are created, CGST, SGST, EGST, and IGST. And this is the very important reform of the credits and recoveries. Previously, this credits and recoveries also is charged to PU 98. It is a very difficult for budget sections to estimate the expenditure because PU 99 earlier is used for expenses as well as credit. One is plus, another is minus. To avoid this confusion and difficulty, they created a separate exclusive PU for credits and recoveries, that is 98. So 99 still remain for only for other expenses. Now we'll check some of the changes in the planets. This is the source of finance. This 20 is the capital, 21 is the DRO, and development fund 1, 2, 3, 4 is the 23, 33, 23, and 53. And capital fund is the 25. And RSF is the 26, and SRSF is still in the books but not in operation because it is already closed to the year 2008-2001. It was established along with the railway safety fund, but 2008 it is closed. And in the place, RRSK is paying the future. That is a capital NPI fund in its 28. That is a function of this, the cameras and all this. Coaches and the railway stations for production of fuel. And RRSK, this is the new fund, 29. And all EPR, it is 82, 83, 84, 83. So first one is PPP. I have been specifically comes to the Institution of Finance. Right now, the LS is the only agency. And EPR IRFC is long back, it is then IRFC. And the EPR special, it is only for the 2022, not now. And we checked major changes in the land. Yeah, this is nothing but big change. Only in the non-petri change. Because the new land construction is here, just a remote construction. Because the new land itself is the construction. That's why they remote this construction. This purchase of new lands is a deleted. And previously we have done at 36 or 37. What is other electrical works, excluding traction distribution works, and for traction distribution works 37 is there. Now both are merged and it is called plan and 36 other electrical works. So there is no 37. And like that, 51 and 52 also merged and changed in plan and 51 stop welfare. Stop welfare means it includes farmers as well as and previously we have three planets of their investments in the government, commercial undertakings, sports services, PSU. Suppose we are invested in money in the Railtel or RBNL or Ethical. So such investments comes under these planets. So PSUs and non-government undertakings also. So all these three clubs are mentioned to only one planet, 61 investments. PSU, JV, and SPP. So these are the planets are deleted, Bali is deleted, Kathleen is deleted, distribution of dispatch lights, and taking over of limelight from 84, that is also deleted. And 83, prior to this merger, new lines construction couldn't is there. So under this planet we are taking up the projects Jammu and Kashmir and the northeastern states. Now after merger, there is no question of dividend. So this planet also new lands construction will be dividend. So after adjusting all these are the existing planets. Please check. Anyway, I shared this PPT. So this is the 22 is recently introduced in 2005. This is the payment of capital component of lease charges to IRFC. On 17 also, 17 and 18 also, recent computation of my research. And this 29, 30 also, road safety crossing, level crossing, and ROP. And these are existing one only. This 65, for mining and HRD purpose, they created one new planet, 65. Is that the? Yeah. Please ask any doubts. I'm going to meet. I'm going to meet all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you. I'm sharing all the PPTs and PPTs. Please wait.
Thank you, sir.
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 Share all the material.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Provide PPT, please, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you,
sir.
Yeah, please, sir. I'm sharing the all the material. Thank you. Yeah, please, any queries? Otherwise, I call it a day. Any more queries?
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
On behalf of Sitara, we thank Mr. Rageshwar Rao for his excellent explanation of various locations. And I hope all the participants would have benefited from this lecture. Tomorrow, same time login, 11 o'clock, class starts at 11:30. Topic is GST basics. This is a very important topic because day to day there are so many changes, and those specially involved in the passing of bills, expenditure section, both stores bills and contractor bills will be very much benefited by tomorrow's lecture. Hope all of you join tomorrow. Login time is at 11 o'clock. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, PPT kaise milega?
Thank you.